How about a cold start video? It's about the only reason I'd be out here. It's 40 degrees in my very cluttered storage barn. My John Deere has not been running a while. I don't like to let it set too long because it's not possible to get all the gas out of the carburetor. Sorry, I'm reaching back here. I do leave a maintainer connected to it. That's a Schumacher. It's just Granger's brand name. So I leave that on the battery. This is the original battery in this tractor, believe it or not. And it'll go 6-8 weeks with the maintainer off of it and still crank the engine reasonably well so it starts. The vehicle was manufactured in 2004, so that's the age of that battery. It doesn't use any water. That charger, that maintainer is apparently just right for it. Let's see if it's going to start. Sitting here in the seat, I'm going to tell you, it's not a day I'd want to be cutting grass. Now, this machine normally will start right up. Let's see, I have to use two hands for this because the choke is manual. So let's just do that and get my knee out of the way. Brake, clutch, depressed, choke, closed, crank. Gradually releasing the choke. Well, it sounds like my battery is just about at the end of its lifespan. Certainly well past what you'd expect. You're seeing an alternator light because it's idling so slow right now. Let that oil get pumped up through the vessels before I speed it up. Then I'll let it run for a while at a couple different speeds. I don't know, 15, 20 minutes. At that point, it should be sufficient to let it set for another month or so safely. The machine has got 214 hours. I'm the second owner. It's been pretty much, you change gas, I mean change oil, put gas in it, lubricate the spindles occasionally, and the kingpins on front, and that's it. Just drive it. I've only changed one belt. That was the primary drive belt for the deck, not the secondary. This is the Kawasaki 17 horse. So got the original spark plug. Way it always runs. I did have carburetor trouble with it a few years ago because I let it set too long, and all the solvent in the world going into the gasoline wouldn't clear it out. So I pulled it off, and it was a quick fix of the low speed jet, and that's it. Didn't even have, when I say pulled it off, I pulled the engine, or pulled the blower housing off. I did not have to remove the carburetor. I want to put the blades on. Again, two-handed operation. I don't know if that view is any good or not. Let's see. All right, so hand on the throttle. I grab the PTO switch. All right, not quite fast enough. Try it again. Not warm enough for that trick. All right. A piece of cardboard sitting underneath the deck. I forgot that was back there. Oops. Well, scared me. No call yet. I don't want to run it too fast. There's more cardboard down there. Thank you. Look what the damn rodents do to my lawn. They do this every year. I'm assuming it's mice, unless it's those little chipmunky things. I don't think they hang out in the cold. Where's Carl, the groundskeeper? Actually, I have some bait. I hate to poison them, but they're making a mess, so I'm afraid I'm gonna dump some bait crystals down after I go in and warm up, because my hands are cold. Burr. Winter in the Midwest. I have to shovel a path on the deck. And there's Gus the cat. Hello, Gus. Well, it's been running for about 20 minutes now. I got busy in the house and forgot it was even out here. Can't complain, as I said earlier, for the years I've had that machine and the two other John Deere's I've owned, they've been quite reliable. And I maintain them, but no complaints. All right, cut it down. Normally now, at normal idle. Now, there's no problem with the charging system, and with that weak battery, who knows? Probably not liking that a whole lot either. Machine. All right, close her up. I go ahead and reconnect the maintainer while it's sitting here parked. Keep my face back because it's been charging now and you never know. All right, and what I do is I take a piece of stick right here. And the thing is hot. I don't like to shut the plastic cover in the barn with a hot engine. So I do that. Back up a little bit. Do that with the stick. Helps me remember I've got the maintainer on too, so I don't drive off and drag the thing down the driveway. All right, close her up. I'm cold, I'm going in the house. When I first put this barn in, I wired it. I'm an electrician, and that's what we do. We wire things. And I put an alarm system in it because it is out in my yard and it's got equipment in it. I also wanted air here from the compressor in the basement. So I took to my shovel and I ran me a trench from the corner of the house there by the block window all the way across, and there's two plastic conduits in the ground and then also a copper line for air. Got low voltage, high voltage, and then air. Copper didn't cost as much back then. And it's hard to see in the dark, but you can see where everything comes in. I've got a moisture trap on the air line, and then I've got some extra cables. There's some coax through there. There's a camera mounted in here that looks at the that part of the house. Mounted up high, so that's a hardwired camera. Back in the old days, there were no Wi-Fi stuff. And then there's tied to the sound system also. So remote switching on the air compressor. There's a 2-horsepower twin compressor in the basement. That's all you do. Now it takes a while to charge the whole system up. And a couple minutes later, you got, you know, system air out here. And she's got a quick disconnect on it because I like to blow the crap and stuff out of the engine when I'm through with the mower. And I'm pretty religious about that. I just blow backwards up where the fins are as best you can and around the spark plug holes and the time I did have the blower housing off, it was clean. There was no debris, no dust built up in the fins, which is, you know, what destroys those things. So, all right, it's a friggin' mess in here too, but there's a original Bobcat mower. That's the self-propelled version. Of course, kind of hard to see hanging up like that. That was my original machine here at the house, but I discovered I like a Honda lawnmower better. All right, I'm cold. Enough chattering. Thanks for watching, everything. Lock her up.